In case you missed it, Richard Pryor's former bodyguard, Rashaan Khan, sat with Comedy Hype 2 weeks ago and detailed his relationship with Pryor, rumors of Paul Mooney's sexuality, Hollywood, and what shocked viewers when he alleged that Mooney sexually violated Richard Pryor's own son, Richard Pryor Jr. Now, in response to the allegations, Paul Mooney's oldest twin sons would talk to Comedy Hype from Los Angeles and address the accusations against their father. They would go on to point out that if there was any truth to the claims, Richard Pryor Jr. should be the one to speak on it. Outside of the allegations, Daryl and Dwayne Mooney would also go on to respond to Khan's claims that Mooney was not a writer for Pryor in a separate clip. Now, people across social media would respond to this story. One Twitter user, @IRTLies, tweeted, "I'm not making any judgments, especially when I know people have a product to promote. Keep laughing, Mr. Mooney." Another Twitter user, @John94Darnell, would go on to tweet, "Paul Mooney is like that cousin in the family. Everybody ignore that they gay, but we all know." Paul Mooney will also issue a statement on Twitter and tweeted the following, "Thank you all for your messages, emails, and calls. As you know, a good laugh is the all be all. I've been checking out some very funny stuff." Now, of course, we have to ask at Comedy Hype, after these new alleged truths, where does Paul Mooney's legacy now stand? All right, so it was a big week at Comedy Hype. Well, actually, big last 2 weeks. Rashaan Khan came to the platform, pretty much detailed his relationship with Richard Pryor. You know, gave us some pretty heavy accusations about Paul Mooney as far as writing for Richard Pryor. He alleged that Paul Mooney molested Richard Pryor Jr. Also alleged that Paul Mooney is a homosexual.
I think if Paul Mooney would come out with the gay folks called come out of the closet, he would be one of the top comedians. It's his hiding in the closet like he's not. Because when people see Paul performance, they hear what he's saying, but they're like, I'm seeing something else. Like, ooh, baby, there's something else there. And because he's saying it black, you try to hide what you're seeing.
Then the Mooney twins come on in defense of Paul Mooney and pretty much dismissed all of the claims.
Yeah, we're very hip to the allegations.
Oh, we are very hip to
we've known Rashaan quite well.
We've known Rashaan,
and you know, how y'all gonna listen to a goddamn bodyguard?
Yeah, I thought it's usually the maid that tells the business, not the bodyguard. Good Lord. Bodyguard out guarding the door.
So it was a lot. A lot was going on.
It is. It's a lot to unpack here. I think the heaviest of it all is, you know, Rashaan came out and said that Paul Mooney molested Richard Pryor Jr. And then TMZ catches up with Richard Pryor Jr. And to me, it didn't seem like he confirmed or denied it, you know. And I think the reason why is probably he didn't want that out there. Because if he did, you know, one of the Mooney twins made a great point. If he did, he would have put it in his book that he wrote a couple of years ago, you know. So I would hope that Rashaan got permission from from Richard Pryor Jr. to put that information out there. He just looked really uncomfortable when he was addressed about it, you know.
Well, he definitely didn't deny it, you know, and it's not something, there's no gray area with, you know, if you were sexually molested or not. It's either like, he didn't come out and say, no, that's not true. So if you don't say that to me, that means you were sexually molested. That's to me. Mm-hmm. But do I think this affects Paul Mooney's legacy, his reputation? I do. I think it affects it. It smears it. Especially as far as if he wrote for Richard Pryor or not. Like, that's what Paul Mooney was known for. That's how he was getting work. You know, comedians were taking him on the road because they were, you know, under the impression that he's writing for Richard Pryor.
Well, the sons definitely defended that. They went into detail. They were there and expressed how they were friends. They were creative partners. They were buddies. They gave each other jokes. Mm-hmm. You know, Richard Pryor hired Paul Mooney as a casting director, as a writer. He trusted him. You know, they were yin and yang. He balanced Richard Pryor out. Mm-hmm. You know, they were friends. So, you know, they were there. So, you know, I think it's safe to say that the man did write for Richard Pryor. You know, it's sad because Paul Mooney is ill and he can't come out and speak and defend himself.
Yeah, which makes me question, you know, why now? Why come out with all of these allegations now?
Because he has a book to promote.
Where Paul Mooney can't defend himself, you know? And then people were saying that, you know, Paul Mooney canceled his show in Atlanta because of these accusations. And it's like, no, his son's, you know, confirmed. No, it's not because of the accusations. He's not even aware of what's going on. Yeah. So he really is at a point where he's ill. And, you know, God forbid if he was to go, it's like, damn, you know, his reputation is legit tarnished.
That's the last page of it. I think that's the worst thing you can do to someone is to make accusations against them when they can't defend themselves. Mm-hmm. You know, but if even when it comes to him being gay, I think, you know, majority of the black community, we kind of all suspected it. I just don't think we cared because he was.
We don't care. We don't care. And one of the things that didn't sit well with me with Rashawn Khan, what he said was, Paul Mooney should come out. If he would come out, then he would be one of the top comedians. And I'm like, he's already one of the GOATs. Like, you can't have a conversation discussing the top five, top 10, and not mention Paul Mooney.
You know what? Eddie Griffin said it best. Eddie Griffin said on a Vlad interview a few years back, he said, black male stars don't leave the business clean. There is a systematic effort to destroy every black male entertainer's image.
I don't think this is any type of conspiracy system thing to bring Paul Mooney down. If Paul Mooney is sleeping with underage boys and it came to light, because please believe, anything you do on this earth is going to come to light before you leave. So if there's truth to that, this isn't a conspiracy. People need to know, and if that turns your reputation, then so be it. I'm back and forth because Paul, as far as if his reputation will be tarnished, because when Paul Mooney came out or he tweeted or, you know, whoever tweeted for him, if he's that ill, I don't imagine him tweeting. But if he did tweet, whoever, that's not the point. He still seems to have a lot of loyal fans. Mm-hmm. People still are going to consider him the great, in my opinion. All right, well, let us know in the comments below, guys. Has these new untold truths tarnished Paul Mooney's legacy? Until next week, it's CJ and Sade with Comedy Hype News.